So in the previous lecture, I have already calculated how you will find E, its mean of the X plus Y, which is a joint probability distribution. So mean you have already the random variable X values and the random variable Y values. So in my previous lecture, I have already show you that how you will calculate these joint probabilities, how you will calculate GX and HY. Then on the basis of those joint probabilities, we calculated EX plus Y, EX minus Y, E, 2X minus 3Y. And today I am just going to show you that how you will calculate X into Y. And the general formula you already know. And if X and Y are independent, and if X and Y are not independent, then what will be the situation? So I am just going to solve this while using the same joint probability distribution, how you will calculate EX plus Y. So you people know that EX plus Y, generally you can write it summation for X, summation for Y, X into Y and PXY. So we have already calculated XY and X into Y. So I am just going to show you this simple example that how you will calculate EXY in Microsoft Excel. So when we calculate all these probabilities, then the main objective of this lecture, how you will verify this probability. Maybe in exam, I ask you that verify these properties while using the basic, the manually calculated and using the variance and mean properties, mean loss to calculate these. So in this lecture, I'm just going to show you that in Excel. So now you can see that we have these two random variable, one is X and the value of 2 and 4 and the Y value are 1, 3, 5. So from this GX, these are the probabilities for when X is equal to 2, so 0.4, for Y is equal to 4, this is the probability, for Y is equal to 1, 0.25, for Y is equal to 3, this one. So when you sum it, it will be 1. If you sum this row, it will be 1. And from this, we just calculate the joint probabilities. When you multiply this, when 2 is this, and for 1 is 0.25. So you will get this when 2 is, so the probability is 0.4. When 3 is, so the probability is 0.5. So you will calculate 0.2. So at this way you will calculate. So in my previous lecture, they asked you that calculate EX plus Y. You can see that in the yellow. So EX plus Y. So for this purpose, because we know that EX plus Y is how we will calculate EX plus Y, because EX plus Y general formula is the same as we already discussed that in the previous lecture, that E X. So normally we write this summation X into P of X, but now we have two random variables, so X Y. So we need to calculate this thing X Y into P X Y, because now this is the case of joint probability distribution. So you can see this is X into Y. So how we will calculate X into Y? You will take X2 multiply with 1, so you will get 2. You need to take X2 and multiply with 3, so 2, 3 is 6. When you take 2 multiply with 5, you will get 10. Similarly, when you take 4 and multiply with Y is equal to 1, you will get 4. 4, 3 is 12 and 4, 5 is 20. And these probability will be same. As you can see, we use these probabilities for X plus Y, for X minus Y and for 2X minus 3Y, which we have already calculated in my previous lecture. Because when you multiply this 2 into 1, so the joint probability is 0.1. So we just find this joint probability. 2 multiplied by 3. So we take X is equal to 2 and 3 is the value of Y is equal to 3. And the joint probability for X2 and Y3 is 0.2. And for the joint probability for 4 and 5 is 0.15. So we just find this 0.15. When we multiply it, so how we will multiply it? It is very easy. Is equal to this multiply by this, and then you need to drag it down. When you drag it down, it will calculate. If you randomly click this, so it takes X into Y 12, multiply their joint probability, which is in the red color, and this is in the blue color. When you multiply these both, you will get this 3.6. Then, as you people know, that E X Y, so this one is equal to summation X Y. So summation means sum. So we just sum. If you can see, we just sum this column. So 9.6 is the mean of E X into Y. Similarly, the E X plus Y mean was 6.2, E X minus Y is 0.2, and the mean of 2X minus 3Y is minus 2.6. So at this way, we will write these values. So please once again note these values for EX plus Y, because I am just going to show you that how you will use while using the laws of mean. So we can easily calculate if you remember the laws of mean. The laws of mean will be ex plus y will be, you just write this, the mean, this ex plus y will be ex plus y will be equal to e of x plus e of y. Similarly, e x minus y will be e x minus e y. Similarly, e 2x minus 3y. So you can write this e 2x minus e 3y. And when you further simplify it, as you people know, it will become out e x minus 3 e y. So now you people know how to calculate these. I will show you that how you will calculate this. So the value of this and the value which we have already calculated, minus 2.6. So this value will be minus 2.6. If you use this formulation or if you use this formulation. Similarly, this will be e x y will be equal to e x into e y. But one thing you need to remember, this will be happen if x and y are independent. If these x and y random variable are not independent, then this will not be the scenario. I will show you an example in which this will not, e x y will not be equal to e x into e y. So I will show you that in a simple example. So from the slide you can see that we have already calculated this value e x y, and we calculated this value 9.6. I already show you that in the Excel how you will calculate. We just x, y, we calculate 2, 6, 10, 4, 12, 20, and then we multiply this with this. When we sum this, we get 9.6. Similarly for ex plus y, so for ex plus y, we have already calculated 6.2. But you also know from the previous slides that ex, so x values are, you have 2x values. How many values you have? X, 2 and 4. And the gx for this was, for 2 it was 0.4 and for 4 it was 0.6. So how you will calculate ex? Let me calculate this for you. So in the next column, x, gx, when you multiply this, you will get the answer. You will get this summation x into gx. And the value of this will be equal to, when you multiply this, it will be 3.2. Similarly for y, the values are 1, 3 and 5, and the probability hy was 0.25 and 0.25. As you can see in the previous slide, we have already calculated these values. Hy is 0.25 0.50 and 0.25. For 1, for 3 and for 5, these are the values of random variable y, and 2 and 4 are the random variable x, and the gx is 0.40 0.60. So we just write these values, and when you multiply this, when you calculate y into hy, so ey value will be equal to summation y into hy. Okay, and this value will be equal to 3. So that is why when you add these two values, which is 3.2, which we get from this, and the other values for ey is 3. So we will get the same value. So this value will be equal to e x plus y, and this thing is equal to double summation x plus y into p x y. So you will get the same value. Similarly in this one, because ex, you can split this, how you will write ex minus ey. So ex is 3.2 minus 3, which will be equal to 0.2, and this value is equal to E x minus y, which is equal to x minus y P x y. So at this way you can verify these properties. Similarly, you can write this 2 E x minus 3 E y. So 2, which is 3.2 minus 3 into 3. So when you calculate this, this will be less than 9 and this will be 9, which will give you the value of minus 2.6. So you can easily calculate if you know these values x gx and y hy. So when you put this, so you not need to do the long interpretation and long calculation. But if your instructor asks you that also verify the properties, then you need to use both methods. You need to solve this with both ways. Okay. Similarly, as I already mentioned in the Excel side, if x and y are independent variable, then Exy will be equal to Ex into Ey. So Ex is 3.2 and Vi is 3, 9.6. And we have already calculated this same value, 9.6. I show you that how you will calculate. We just calculate x into y, and then in the next step, we just do this, and in the next step, x into y into Pxy. So the summation x into y into Pxy. So this value was Exy, which is equal to 9.6. So if you want to use this, simply Ex, which is 3.2, and Ey is 3. So it will give you the same value. But if x and y are independent variable, if x and y are independent variable, then probability of xy is equal to gx into hy. Okay, the probability of this, its mean probability of x into probability of y, will be equal to g of x into h of y. So at this way you will interpret the results. Thank you.